Hi there, it's Jake here from Get Your Pet Right. Today we're at Kellyville Pets with very, very well-known vet, Dr. Shane Simpson. Welcome, Shane.
Thank you.
Today you gave a lecture on reptile viruses.
Yep.
Just to let some people know, what are the most common viruses found in captivity?
Yeah, so we look at snakes, for example. We have in Australia a virus called Sunshine Virus. That's by far the most common one that we see. And there's also another virus called Borna virus, and both of those viruses cause neurological problems in snakes where they lose the ability to right themselves, put them on their back and they can't flip back over. They do what we call stargazing, where they sort of go back, that's right, yeah, and they look up at the sky, and they'll often become weak in the back end. So they're the two snake viruses that we most commonly see. The other virus that's a concern is in big dragons. They get a virus called adenovirus, and that can cause in young dragons a similar sort of problem where they'll actually not be able to coordinate the movements and the head will go back. In the older dragons, they'll go on and develop a hepatitis and they lose weight and they get sick from that. So not good at all, but you can also have dragons that can be infected and actually live a perfectly healthy life all of their lives. So it's not necessarily death sentence with them, but people need to be aware of that virus.
Yep. So if anyone out there does suspect their virus or their reptile have any of these particular viruses, please take it to a reptile vet. Very, very important. Must go to a reptile vet. Now, to deviate a little bit from that, on our last meeting we had a little thing about the UV lighting and
yep.
everything else. I just want to touch base on the UV index.
Yes.
Because a lot of people see on the UVB meter and stuff like that, no one really talks about the index side of it.
Yep.
What would be the best recommendation for the UV index and how does it actually work?
Yeah, how does it work? So basically, a UV index is in broad terms, is a measure of the sunburning ability of a light. And so people will be familiar with UV index from looking at the weather reports on the news, and during summer they'll say, oh, UV index is high, for example. So
yeah.
There's a good chance that you going out in that sun is going to cause a sunburn. So what the measurement actually goes is from 0 to 11 is the normal sort of range. What we know is anything above about a 7 to 8 is getting into dangerous territory. Certainly anything at 11 is highly,
very, very high. Stay inside.
Correct, yeah. So now what the UV index does is a measure of how safe that globe is, and it also gives you an idea of how far away from the globe you need to set, or how much distance you need between the globe and the closest that the animal can get. So if you've got a globe that's producing a UV index and it's pumping out at say 30 centimetres, you measure it with a metre, and it's at 11, that distance is too short. You're going to risk that animal getting effectively sunburn or having some serious problems with eye damage. So you need to push that line, add that further away from that globe. Now what varies is the different species. And so some species like a low UV index, something like a children's python, for example, coastal carpet python, nocturnal boys forest dragons are even better examples. So they like a very low UV index. Whereas you go to the other end of the extreme and you get things like painted dragons, which sit out in the middle of the daylight, in the middle of the desert, in the middle of the sun, getting lots of UV at a high UV index. So you need to do some research and have a look at where does that animal come from. And there are, you can jump online and the Bureau of Meteorology and those sort of places have measurements of what the average UV index is in certain locations. And you can actually tell and say, right, that animal lives there, it needs a UV index about that, and try and match that in your actual enclosure.
As best you sort of can.
As best you can, so, because you're trying to take a mini natural climate inside your actual enclosure. Now, in order to actually measure UV index, you need to have the right meter, and that's called a solar meter 6.5.
Yep.
There is another meter called a solar meter 6.2. That measures a completely different thing when we're talking about UV. But if you want to measure UV index, you need the 6.5. And you can measure safety, and you can measure safe distances to have that from the animal, and make sure you're not going to hurt your animal by actually having a light that is incorrectly located and faulty. You get some globes that are actually faulty and produce far too much and can really cause some serious damage.
Okay. Now, for everyone out there who is worried about any sort of this information with the indexes or not, at Kellyville Pets, Get Your Pet Right, we actually have come up with this pamphlet. If you actually open up the back of it, we do have a small temporary guide that you can actually look up, which is right there. All these pamphlets are available at Kellyville Pets. Shane, thank you so much for your lecture.
My pleasure.
I do believe you have something coming out soon.
So with the lecture I'm giving tonight, we're going to be looking at doing that in a couple of different cities, so probably Melbourne, Brisbane, maybe even heading up north. But importantly, we're going to have an ebook coming out of all the notes, and so I'll have that available for purchase on my at my shop, which is www.thereptiledoctorshop.com.au.
Lovely, no worries. All right, so guys, please keep a lookout for that little booklet, and great to have you here, Shane. Thank you everyone for watching. Thank you.
See ya.